A year ago at this time, we were in the midst of a hard-fought primary campaign for U.S. Senate. Four Republicans, including a former governor, former congressman, former assembly speaker, and successful businessman, slugged it out, only to have the winner of the August primary, Tommy Thompson, lose to Democrat Tammy Baldwin in November. I mention this because a year from now, we may or may not be in a primary campaign for governor, as Democrats try to decide who will face incumbent Scott Walker in November of 2014. Recently, in his blog, former Madison Mayor Dave Cieslewicz made a strong case for a contested Democratic primary. Cieslewicz maintains it would be good for the party and electorate, good for the Democratic process. He doesn't like the idea of the Democratic candidate being chosen by party power brokers behind closed doors. But the specter of what happened to Republicans a year ago is something Democrats can hardly ignore. Could a contentious party primary like the one last summer make the winner more vulnerable? Would it deplete that candidate's funds, money that will be sorely needed to run against an incumbent with very deep pockets? Would Democrats be better off following the Baldwin model? One well-financed candidate, no primary. Democrats are united in their desire to defeat Governor Walker, but the means to that end is sure to spark some spirited internal discussions in the weeks ahead. Thanks for being with us today. I'm Mike Gousha, and I'll see you again next week on Upfront.
You can see today's program on our website. Just click on the Upfront section of WISN.com.